How are we all doing, YouTube? And welcome to Season 1, Episode 3 of Barrowcelona. Firstly, please press the subscribe button and hit the bell notification so you're notified when new episodes are uploaded. And also, if you could hit the like button if you enjoy the video, it would be great, and it would also help the visibility of the channel and is very much appreciated. So on with the housekeeping out of the way. As you can see, I've loaded a new skin into the game. This one is by Yacs, Y-A-C-S, link to which you can find in the description. I chose this one because it's one of only a few that seem to work well at 125% zoom, which is how I like to play the game, and also I think it works better visually for the channel. Let me know what you think of the new skin in the comments. So, when you was last with us, we picked up a 1-0 win away to Eastleigh, courtesy of a John Rooney penalty. Since then, it hasn't gone too bad. We were next at home to Torquay, where we lost 3-2, thanks to a late winner in the dying seconds of injury time. I felt hard done by in this game, to be honest. I still cannot believe that we lost this game. It was all us for the first 70 minutes, but then Torquay just bombarded us in the last 20 minutes, and their persistence came up dividends in the end. We had goals from Josh Kay and another John Rooney penalty, but if you look in the stats, I mean, it does look quite even, so it did look as if a draw would have been a fair result, but Torquay hadn't even got into double figures with their shots until the last 20 minutes. And Scott Quigley also had a poor game in this one. It was, he still hadn't scored for us up until this point, which was quite disappointing. So I was in two minds whether to play him in our next game, which was away to Wrexham. But as you can see, he scored two goals, his first goals of the season, and picked up the Man of the Match award. Two assists from Bonds as well. We played really well in this game. We definitely deserved the win. And good result all round. Next up, we drew two each at Sullyhole Moors. Again, another John Rooney penalty to give us the equaliser and pick up the point. We didn't play too good in this game. Good performance from Mitchell Parker, scoring on his first start for the club. And John Rooney scored as well with another penalty. I was happy to come away with the draw because it probably flattered us a bit. And then finally, we picked up a 2-1 win at home to Bromley, which in this case, this result flattered them. We absolutely dominated the game. Kay got the Man of the Match award as well as a goal. Two assists from Bradley Barry on the right there from his crosses. And yeah, again, we left it very late in the third minute of injury time. But it was, it was a good win and I was very pleased with it. If you look at the stats, I mean, yeah, we dominated it. We had double the amount of shots that they had, numerous blocked shots, clear-cut chances, only narrowly beat them to it, but we dominated possession again and continuing to play the really good football. Into second place, only 2 points behind the leaders, Chesterfield. A few points clear of the playoff places, which, as you can see, is very close at the moment. So a couple of defeats and we're out of the playoffs. So we want to keep on going with this double live comm today with both games at home against Dover, who are 14th, and Sutton, who are just outside the playoffs in 8th position. Okay, I just wanted to highlight the finances here because something's come up that's concerned me. At the beginning of the season, we had just over 14,000 in the bank, and then that peaked with our season ticket sales and the revenue from our friend list to 66,000. Now, in the space of just 2 months of the season, we're now 90 grand in debt with a projection of just over 500,000 by the end of the season, which is obviously a concern. And with our average attendance of only just, I think we're just over 1,200, yeah, just over 1,200, which is one of the lowest in the division, we haven't got much room for manoeuvre when it comes to finances. So I'm hoping that the attendances will increase. I mean, we're second already, and I'd like us to get our attendances up to about 2,000 to help us with the revenue side between now and the end of the season. But I guess we'll just have to we'll wait and see on that one. So I just wanted to do a quick squad review. As you can see, John Rooney is the highest rated player with an average rating of 7.28. 5 goals, 4 assists and all 10 appearances so far. He had 4 of his goals have come from penalties and the other one was a direct free kick. But as you can see, he has been key for this season, like I said in the first episode. And he's been really good for us. Josh Kay is next, our left winger. He's got an average rating of 7.12 with 6 goals and 1 assist. Next up is Matthew Platt at the back, who has been absolutely solid in the defence with an average rating of 7.04. And then Elliot Bonds next in the midfield with 2 assists and 2 goals with an average rating of 7.04. Also, as you can see, I've brought in a trialist. We are short on cover in the midfield. I think I said in the last episode that I was looking to get this guy recalled back from loan. He's on loan to... Who's he on loan to? He's on loan to Blythe. But he's, I'm unable to recall him from his loan, which is disappointing. So I've got this guy in as a trialist who looks pretty decent. 2.5-star current rating, up to 5-star potential. He would be mainly to come in as cover for Jason Taylor. So hopefully we'll be able to bring him in as well. And then that takes us on to the next game, which is at home to Dover, who are 14th in the league. So in goal, we've got Shelby. Back four is unchanged with Brow, Parker, Platt and Barry on the right. Midfield three, still the same with Rooney, Taylor and Bonds. Greaves on the right and Kay on the left with Quigley up front. He had picked up food poisoning, so he's only just come back from fitness, but he's due to return to full fitness imminently, so I will be starting him for this game. So this is a game we should be winning, so we will, this is normally a good one to use. Great opportunity to show all the pundits that they have been right to back you up. Okay, good response. Let's get into the game and get a win. Brow throws to Quigley. Quigley back to Brow. Parker inside to Platt. This is good football. Greaves picks it up on the right. Is he going to knock it out wide? No, and he tries to go for the cross but wins a corner. I thought he was going to knock it to Barry there out on the right. Might have been the better option. Rooney with the corner. Parker tries to have a shot, but that's a typical centre-backs trying to strike there. And it's free kick as Rooney was offside. Barry with the throw to Quigley. Bonds crosses it in and Kay! And he heads it in and scores. Great start, 12 minutes on the clock and Josh Kay gets his 7th goal of the season with an assist by Elliot Bonds. Again, another well-worked goal there from the throw. Quigley to Bonds. Bonds crosses it in and Kay heads it in. Brilliant goal. So they got the free kick out on the left here. Jeffrey whips it in, but Shelby does a good job and catches it easily. So Quigley tries to win it in the air there, but it comes back to them. Legoul, if that's how you say his name. Couldn't get the cross in there, but Kay picks it up now. Turns inside. He's dribbling with it well there. Knocks it out wide to Greaves. Can Greaves get the cross in? Crosses it in and it's headed out by their defence. But Greaves picks it up again on the edge of the box and scores a cracking goal. What a strike from the edge of the area. I wasn't expecting that. I thought he was going to try and pass his way back in. But yeah, it was Greaves initially with the cross. And it came back out. He picks it up again on the edge of the area and just rifles it into the keeper's right-hand side of the goal. Brilliant goal. Barry with the throw to Taylor. Knocks it back to Barry. Barry crosses it in and it's headed out. Can Taylor have a shot? No. Knocks it to Quigley. Quigley shoots and the keeper saves it. Rooney with the free kick in and Kay. And it just goes wide. showing how dangerous we are from these set pieces. And we get to half-time, 2-0 up. Great score, great performance so far. Can't fault the lads, really. I'll tell the lads not to get complacent. I always do this when, even if we're 2 goals up by half-time, I still tell them to get not to get complacent. It generally gets a positive response. You might get one or two that get distraught over it, but it's normally quite effective as a team talk. So they've got the free kick on the right. Jeffrey whips it in. It's headed out. Kay picks it up and knocks it out. No nonsense there. So Quigley comes out wide. Beats his man. Can he shoot? But it's an easy shot for their keeper to save. So 70 minutes. Time to make a sub. Yes, Quigley's looking very tired there. So let's bring on Angus. I think with Brow, maybe we might not make him as attacking. Let's just put him on the support role. I don't really want to put somebody... don't want to put Hurd, who's not... obviously, he's not a left back, so we'll just leave it at that for now. Rooney with the corner. But it's easily headed out there by Reason. Parker knocks it back to Brow. Brow back out to Rooney. What can he do with it here? Knocks it inside to Kay. Kay to Angus. Angus has a shoot, but it's a great save there by their keeper. And as we go into the last few seconds of injury time, looks like we're going to come away with the win. Come on, ref, blow the whistle now. And he has done. And it's Barrow 2, Dover Athletic 0. Well-deserved victory there. Again, another match that we have dominated. Brilliant, brilliant result. Brilliant performance by the lads. Yeah, very pleased with the result and the performance. Great ratings there. Oliver Greaves got man of the match after a very poor start to the season. He seems to be coming back into it. He got a goal. Josh Kay with a goal as well. Both the wingers scoring there. And an assist from Elliot Bonds. Defence played really well. Yeah, on to the next game then. Okay then, so just one thing to note. We did sign Jack Kearsey in the end after his trial period. Just a quick overview. He's 2.5-star current ability, up to 5-star potential. He's going to be more in the defensive sort of area, although he can play in an attacking role. He's just as good as a defensive ball-winning midfielder. So that's good. Plenty of versatility there. Plenty of options, which is what we want for him, as he's going to be covering the main midfield three. But good stats all round. Good marking. Good determination, flair, leadership. Good physical stats. So yeah, he's got the potential to improve. So that's, you know, hopefully we'll see him break through into the team at some point. So, for today's game against Sutton United, who are 8th in the league, we will have an unchanged team. I don't really see any need to make any changes. Again, Shelby in goal, Brow, Parker, Platt and Barry in the back four, Rooney, Taylor and Bonds the midfield three, Kay on the left, Greaves on the right and Quigley up front. This will be Quigley's last game. If he doesn't score in this game, I might have to give one of the other two strikers a go. Who have we got? Dior Angus or Jack Hindle. So yeah, I'll give one of those two a go if Quigley fails to score, or at least put in a decent performance for today. Okay then, yeah, so yeah... Yeah, carry on from the last game. Not a bad reaction. Let's put in another good performance and hopefully another good win. Okay, Barry with the throw. Taylor knocks it to Bonds. Bonds inside to Rooney. Rooney back to Taylor. Taylor plays it out left. A great ball to Brow. Brow plays it to Quigley and Quigley scores! That was, again, another well-worked goal and a brilliant celebration there by Scott Quigley. I'm so pleased he's got a goal there. hopefully he can go into a fine vein of form now and score a few more goals. It was a great cross there, and Quigley heads it in. Rooney with the free kick in. Their goalkeeper picks it up nice and safely. Oh! What happened there? Well, that's the first time I've seen anything like that on Football Manager. But, oh, it's been disallowed for offside. I thought it was a bit weird that both the players were... I mean, is that still a free kick these days if you block the goalkeeper like that? I don't know. Yeah, very odd. So, not much else has happened in the first half. I mean, Sutton haven't been in it at all. Now, saying that now, I've now jinxed it, haven't I? So, they're coming through here with this guy's name, who I'm not going to even bother trying to pronounce. Eastman has a shot, but it deflects off his own man. And, oh, he keeps it in. And it's a free kick. So, we go into half-time, 1-0 up. Again, another game that we seem to be dominating possession-wise. Sutton had that little scare there towards the end of the first half. Yeah, again, it's not this guard against complacency. Why is that like that for? That's better. So they've knocked it forward there. They're keeping possession well here. They've knocked it forward to Jarvis, and he should have scored there, but it was a great save by Shelby. But it didn't matter because Jarvis was offside. Okay, let's look to make a substitution here. Greaves isn't playing very well. So let's bring on Angus on the right there. Is there anything else we can change? Nope, we'll leave it at that. See how we go on for the next 10 minutes. So I am concerned that we haven't established more of a cushion on this game. We really need to get that second goal. Brow picks it up here. Okay, inside to Rooney. Rooney to Taylor. Taylor back out to Brow. Rooney picks it up again to Taylor. Some good passing play here. Can Brow get the cross in? And he does. And Angus heads it, but it's easily saved by their keeper. Right, I am concerned about Brow and his conditioning there, so we will bring on Sam Hurd. Put him as an inverted wing back. Yeah, put him as defend, I think. So they got the free kick here, and they've knocked it over to Jarvis. It's a great save by Shelby. He got some sort of a touch, and it was enough to knock it round the side of the post. They've got the corner here. I'd be really disappointed if they get a goal, but they've headed it over, which is good. Rooney with the free kick. Oh, and what a goal. Just like his brother, he just can score some cracking goals. That's his second direct free kick. He the curl on that around the wall there. Look at that. Wow, that was Roberto Carlos-esque. And that was a bit of a mouthful. I've been starting to do shouts as well. I've had a look on FM Base with Zealand, and he does a good video clip on shouts. I'll put a link to that in the description, and it's been working quite well for me. There's only three shouts really that Zealand has found that are effective in different situations, and this is one of them. After you've just scored, if you praise them, and it gives them that boost, and yeah, it tends to work. But we've got that two goal cushion now, so that's the main thing. Bonds has knocked it out to Angus. That's a good tackle there by Wyatt. But Angus has picked it up again inside to Barry. Barry shoots, but it came off our own player there, I think. But Jarvis has picked it up. Can they get us on the break? And Platt's fouled him, so it's a free kick. Good lift with the free kick over, and Jarvis skies it. So as we go into injury time, another win, another clean sheet, another good performance. It's going really well. Hopefully we might have moved into top position now. I didn't check the league table after the last game, to be honest. Forgot to do that. And there it is. Another win. 2-0. Back-to-back Livecom wins. Yeah, brilliant. Another goal from John Rooney. And very importantly, Scott Quigley got on the score sheet as well. John Rooney got man of the match there. Great ratings again. Defence is playing so well. Platt and Parker. Since Parker's come in, he's formed up a good partnership there by the looks of it with Platt. So there we have it. We're still second, but only just on goal difference there. Well, I say just. Chesterfield have got 8 goals on us. But yeah, we've got closer, which is good. And we've created a bit of a gap between us and an eighth place for the playoffs. So brilliant. Back-to-back wins makes such a huge difference. Really pleased with that. Okay then, so for the next two live comms, we do have an FA Cup fourth qualifying round match away to King's Lynn Town. And we've also got Notts County and Yeovil. I think what I'll do is I'll play these four games offline and then come back for the Dagenham and Redbridge game and Chorley at home. Dagenham are 18th and Chorley are 20th. So yeah, we'll come back for those two. Hope you've enjoyed today's episode. If you have, don't forget to press the like button as well as subscribe and hit the bell notification so you don't miss an episode. And thanks again for watching. Take care.